Hello friends, welcome to Lockdown Creativity Part 3. Well, with no shops open and the lockdown continuing, I had no other option but to make some paper flowers. So this time I thought I'll make this favorite flower of mine, the hibiscus flower. And I used crepe paper and of course the broomstick, and then the yellow paper I had, I used them to make the anthers. I also made a bud. It turned out to be quite well. It looks beautiful. And many commented that it looked original too. In fact, I even used this for my online teaching to describe the parts of the flower to the students. The students were very happy and they even personally messaged me to tell and describe how I made this flower. I was really happy about it. I also made a bunch of flowers by using the crepe ribbons that we use for our birthday decorations. This is the old way of making it, you know, just folding it alternatively and then pulling the string. We all have done this during our childhood days. But it turned out to be beautiful roses. Roses of various colors, I should say. But it's fun time, a lockdown entertainment. That's all. And then I put all these flowers into a flower pot. This was a dull one, so I cut some design on A4 size paper. I stuck on this flower pot to make it attractive, and then placed all my flowers in that pot. It looked good. And then I had no other option but to do some kitchen quotes. This kitchen quote is written on an A4 size paper. Although it looks simple and beautiful too, but it took quite a good time of mine. The calligraphy, the paint, and the design, and the spacings. It was not very easy as I thought it was, but the end result was very, very good. I love this kitchen quote, and once the lockdown ends, I'm going to frame it up. I also tried with some funny kitchen quote. You know, I went through the net and I got this quote. I modified it. You know, I just made it today's menu. Eat if you like, starve if you dislike, or cook. Kitchen is on the right. It is a funny quote and I like the way I have written it. I made it. My daughter loved it too. But my husband was not in favor of this. He said it's very rude. Eat, starve, or cook? It sounded rude. And on second thoughts, even I thought so. So somehow, although I liked it, I've just kept it in my file. I have not framed it up. And then this is our nameplate. Again, on A4 size paper, I wrote this. And I colored it by using sketch pen, Menon's Abode. And Menon's Abode has got smiles and gardens and tools and dance. And we are all environmentalists. We love environment. And so the abode is full of shelters of different animals. We love animals. We believe in leave and let leave. And so this is the Menon's Abode. With a shy, smiling sun, with all green plants and the lucky plants and the butterfly. I just loved this quote. I loved the way I have done it. Yes, it looks childish, but this was a time when I started doodling. I'll tell you what is doodling and how I started it in my next video. Well, that was also a part of my lockdown creativity. So that's it. The Menon's Abode. All of you are welcome to our sweet little Menon's Abode. How did you like it? Did you like the creativities? If yes, do comment, do let me know. See, the colors were very less, but I managed it. Bye.